At South Louisiana Bank, we're great at banking, but we're great at a lot of other stuff, too.
Is that a new rod and reel?
Hey, a girl's got a fish.
We care about the community we live in and the people we serve. We're not just like you. We are you.
Are you boiling crawfish?
No, just letting them soak.
We're proud to be here and work for the place and the people we love. South Louisiana Bank. It's in the name.
And welcome back to Bayou Time, a very tragic story coming out of Terrebonne Parish. By now, all of you have heard about the young boy who was killed in a school bus accident yesterday in Terrebonne Parish. Joining us on the news desk is the superintendent of Terrebonne Parish Schools, Bubba Angeron. And Mr. Angeron, obviously, before we get into some of the things that are being circulated that I know you want to correct, just your thoughts on this tragic accident. I know it's hit everybody in the school system as well as outside, but just your thoughts.
It's devastating. You know, I didn't know Jeremiah, but in speaking with his teachers and the principal, he was a great kid. Great kid, loved by his, he had friends in his class and all loved him, you know, and his family loved him, adored him. So it's just, for lack of a better word, it's devastating, you know. So we extend our just heartfelt sympathies to the family. Not a whole lot of words can make it any better, but we want them to know we feel for them so much.
You know, and as we sit here, when I found out yesterday, and it's, like I said, I've been on this news desk 40 years. There's nothing worse than when a child gets killed in an accident.
No.
And what makes it worse, and I got to be honest, is that when you start reading some of the social media blogs, I just don't know if some people have any kind of sense of what people are going through. And we could take it all the way to the school bus driver. Some people make up stories. And, you know, where there's fault, there's fault. But where there's no blame, there shouldn't be blame placed without the facts.
That's a good way to put it, yeah.
You know, so let's talk about, there's a lot of things circulating on social media about the school bus driver had a heart attack and different things. I want to hear from you, the superintendent. Maybe you can put some facts to it.
So, yeah. So I heard that a few times today, and transportation department spoke with him several times this morning. And so nothing had happened as of noon today. So we're pretty sure he's fine and okay. He's struggling. He is in a difficult place, you know. But as far as him having anything like that happen, that's inaccurate. You know, the other things we heard that he fled the scene. He didn't flee. But there may have been a chance that he delivered kids after not even knowing what happened, you know? So I think those kind of things, you know, not to deflect, like you said, or defend, but there are some things that are probably not accurate that we're going to hear throughout this whole process. And he's struggling.
I know you well enough, and I know the state police well enough. And as information becomes available, we will bring it to the public. We will let them know. And like I told you before, maybe I've just become this way after so many years on the news desk, but there's really some things in stores that people have no need to hear, especially with a seven-year-old.
Yeah, and I think, too, Martin, is that, you know, we have to step back and think about the family, you know, and I think they were actually requesting not to post stuff, you know, not to put things out there, you know, just to give them space.
Yeah.
So I think that's very important in a situation like this, that rumors don't take off. Where it just makes the situation for the family even worsened, you know, by hearing and having people question them about things that are not true.
Yeah. And we do know factually that he was a substitute driver, wasn't he?
That's right.
Yeah. So, obviously.
And he was employed by us since the latter half of last year. So he had been on the bus for, you know, this wasn't his first route. You know, he's right. had some experience. And he was, I didn't know him, but he was a good driver so far. You know, I mean.
And you know, I mean, we certainly don't wish terrible anything accident. Ever like that on a family, but we don't wish it on the family of somebody who's actually going through this. And I'm sure that he is turning his mind over 1,000 times on this incident.
Yeah, you have to, yeah.
It's just a tough thing. And, and like I said, I don't normally get consumed by news stories, but when things like Ezekiel Harry incident happens and things that happen with Jeremiah happen, we're all human beings. Mm-hmm. And you just go through it and think about what actually took place. But we appreciate you definitely coming on. And I guess you're sort of relying on the state police for the logistics of it. And I'm sure they're staying in touch with you.
They are. They were here at our bus garage investigating all the specs on the bus. You know, we're able to track the speed, the you know, the stops, everything, and you know, examine the bus. And now they're getting some of the other video footage and stuff like that, so that's going to be like all next steps, part of the finalizing the investigation.
And I know with about 50 seconds left, y'all are providing counseling for anybody who needs it.
We have our own licensed professional counselors in the school who do a phenomenal job with kids and also a lot of adults. Mm-hmm. And teachers need it as well as kids, just people to express where they're at, you know, emotionally. So, like I mentioned earlier on the previous segment, is young kids are not sure how to process what they know, what they hear their parents talking about, what they may have seen. Mm-hmm. So having a trained adult speak with them is critical. It's crucial.
Well, we appreciate
the process.
Yeah, we appreciate you coming on board and letting us know. And God bless you and God bless the family of them.
Yes,
and hopefully y'all can get through it as peacefully as possible.
Yes,
all right, there you have it. Take a short break. We'll be right back. Today's social media segment is brought to you by Terrebonne General Health System. Your health is our legacy. Rouse's, you're either local or you're not. Buick, the craft of modern luxury. St. Martin and Bourke, know your rights.